Hello family, this is Gamers Forum back with another interesting video on Clash of Kings. So guys, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe it on because this channel is fully focused on tips and tricks regarding Clash of Kings. You'll get all the necessary data and details over each and every event over this channel. So guys, in today's video, we are going to talk about that why big players or every player used to train T3 and T2 troops in their castle. And we are going to explain that what are their benefits and what are their drawbacks if you train too much of them, guys. So let's begin the video without wasting any time. First, let me tell you that what are the T3 and T2 troops, why they are used and what is the main purpose, guys. Well, we know that the T3 and T2 troops are the lower level troops. If we talk about the lower level troops, don't think that all the troops below T10 comes under that. No, guys. Whenever we are going to talk about the defending thing and about training thing, only T2 and T3 are going to help you at that particular phase. Because T2 and T3 troops are easy to be trained, it consumes less of the resources, and if they get wounded, you can easily heal up without consuming main sources. Means you don't need mithril and iron for healing them. So that is why T2 and T3 are the best lower level troops that can be trusted for the training purpose and for the defending purpose. So that's the reason we select T2 and T3 for the defending on. And now let's talk about that, what is the reason why we trust them and how this whole scenario of attacking and defending works on. So guys, first let me explain that how the attack takes place. When we talk about the attack, guys, keep in mind that whenever someone is going to attack you, the particular troop of enemy, whether you are being beaten by a rally or anything, the thing just work in layers, guys. As I have explained in one of my previous video only, that everything works on layering. So the particular hit used to hit your castle in two different layers. The first layer of the enemy troops will hit your higher level troops, guys. Mind my words, guys, don't miss anything. The first layer of the opponent troop will hit your higher level troops. That is the main purpose out here. Okay guys, so means the higher level troops of your castle got wounded and been turned to the hospital. But the second layer of enemy troop will hit again, try to hit out the second layer of your castle. If you don't have T2 or T3 troops, it will directly again hit the higher level troops on the second layer and you will lose the higher level troop. But if you have T2 and T3 troops, it will go for the lower level troops, means it comes on the layering purpose. The same thing works here also. First troop of the enemy used to hit the higher level troops, and second troop layer of the enemy try to hit the lower level troops. If you have lower level troops, the lower level troops are being hit and they will get directly being killed because your hospital is already being fulfilled by the previous hit. So that's how the scenario works now. But if you don't have the lower level troop, then the second layer also hit the higher level troops and you will lose a lot of troops and you will just go down to a complete failure out here. So that's the reason that why T2 and T3 are trained. I think that you guys mind that what is the real purpose of this training out here. So I hope that you understand this thing. You are very smart people, I know that. And that's why I'm just trying to help you out. So basically, yeah, guys, yesterday only I was just offline and I was being hit by 1.8 million, more than 1.8, around 2 million of rally is being hit my castle. He is quite stronger in stats, but none of the buff is being activated on my castle. But my all stats are being on defending because I was offline. I don't use shield, so I keep my stats on defending purpose. So you can see out the report. I defended that particular rally of 2 million of opponent, but the reason is that my T3, guys. Yes, my T3 help a lot in this particular one, guys. Why I'm saying so, you can see out here, I get 1.1 million of wounded because my hospital capacity 1.1 million. Apart from that, guys, I got 1.4 million killed. When we scroll up and open out the report, you will understand that what are the things that helped me out here. Let's scroll down out here. Where it is. Oh man, they send a lot of... Okay, let's start out here. You can see out here all my higher level troops, my T10, T11, everything, all the higher level troops get wounded because their first layer just hit my higher level troops. That is being obvious. And you see the second layer hit the lower level troops, and you can see T3 of the siege, guys. You can see 0.6 million of T3 of siege got killed. Again, let's move. As you can see, T3 of archers, 0.4 million of T3 of archers got killed, and all my higher level troops are just being saved because of the T3, guys. You said T3 of cavalry got hit, T2 of soldiers are hit, and rest something like same thing happens with all of my troops. Means all my higher level troops got saved, only T2, T3 troops are being hit. And that's what is the reason, guys, after losing around 2.4 million of troops, my reduction of power is just around 9 million, guys. So that's the reason why T2 and 3T works out. That doesn't matter that you are holding a P5, strong P5 or a P4 or a P5. That doesn't matter. On the things works on is that what strategy you are using in your castle, guys. So you should be prepared about each and everything, because casualties or attack can be done in this game at any phase. You should be alert about this one for that. And guys, if you think that you keep on training T3 and T2 only and you don't have higher level troops to get enemy god damage from your side, then it is a total failure, guys. You should have different layers of troops. I'm talking about different layers means higher level troops. As you can see, I have 1 million of each kind of T11. Okay, I have around 200k of T12 of each kind. And I have some of the T13 that I get from different of the event, around 30 to 40,000. That's all the maximum amount. So these are the troops that I have for the attacking purpose. So these are the things that is giving the damage to the enemy. But I have around 6 million of each kind of T3, around 1 million of each kind of T2, just for the defending purpose. So that's all works on here. And if we talk about my power, I'm having power around 118 million of power I'm having on. And at this particular scenario, you can see out here, I lose a lot of troops, but I heal most of them because it is very obvious, because I used to engage in battle very frequently, daily I used to engage in battle. So that's just on. So the thing that whenever you are defending a rally, keep in mind that you should have lower level troops for the defending purpose. Try to train up, because they are easy to train, they consume less resources and thing. But don't train them if you don't have higher level troops for the attacking or defending purpose, guys. They are only effective when you have higher level troops for defending purpose, because they are only made just for saving out your higher level troops, guys. So I think that I have explained you everything that is being necessary for you. And guys, don't think that just training out these things will help you. You should have a better hospital capacity also, so that you can save as much as T11 and T12 or higher level troops as much as you can, guys. For that you need a big hospital capacity. If you don't know how to increase out hospital capacity, then you can check out the end portal of the video. You will get the video link of the 2 million hospital capacity video, and you will learn from there. That's all about today's video, guide. I hope that I have helped you with everything. I have explained you everything. You got the words that I've said in this video, and you will implement this thing and try to defend out a big rally, whether it is from a big spender also. So that's all about today's video, guys. Hope you like the video content. If you find the video information useful, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for sure. I will be back with another video as soon as possible. Till then, keep growing with Gamers Forum. Thank you, guys.